Okay, so I stretched a little. Where am I? All right. So let's log in. We have a reasonably clean slate and we're at 10:15. So everything is still looking dandy. Nice. Let's do this same stuff, but then grab execute because we have more. Software auto of auto run software. Now it's going to check the whole Nautilus suite. Where is? User bin, Nautilus auto run. Copy. Naut auto R. Go to the TE file and do the routine again. So these are the things that we need to confine first, ideally, of course. We need to then also find a way to test this stuff, and that's a problem if you confine the desktop. There are so many ways to use it, so and so many different features and stuff that to make it actually really work. In many situations, it's rather hard. Where is G shell? Exactly. Install. And then do it all over again. Until it has everything that it needs to run. Oh, actually, I'm going too fast. Going too fast makes you error, and if you error, then you're wasting time. And time is money. And money is important, well, to some people at least. Okay, let's see what we have. Same stuff. Oh, actually, we have some new interesting. Canberra wants to search deconf home tree. Where is Canberra? Deconf home tree. And that's, of course, for this stuff. You can't get to data if you can't get if you can't traverse deconf. Get attribute. But what business does it have in data? That's the question. See, so testing does indeed expose new things. Just not many. But they're usually pretty important. On to the next. Noom terminal. And yes, we need to basically confine that. Where is it? Easy bin. That's basically one of the first things I'd like to confine. I want a shell. G terminal. G term. Not sure if that's a good idea, but term. But these are the applications that we are going to have to deal with first. These need to work. But currently it's just testing, seeing if they are there, and if there aren't, then it's he's going to complain. That's why we are just making sure that but of course eventually GNOME Shell will need to be able to run bin, but with a very limited set of permissions. Don't forget to restore Chrome terminal. But so far it looks really, GNOME Shell looks really clean. I'm really pleased to see that. It's just a lot of programs, but it's yeah, it's pretty clean. And yeah, I saw GNOME 2 compared to GNOME 2, it's just great. So I can't complain when it comes to GNOME 3. Some real progress. Still executing them. There's more it needs. What's this time? That's weird, I don't see anything. Log off. Dead. Now this is the next phrase. It is let's just seems that currently let's just see. So now we're going to just try in a forcing mode now. Boom, it creeps out. So 10:29. Here we have something. So now this is also going to take a while. To get it to actually log in. See this stuff, you don't see it when you just, but once you start trying it, then you all of a sudden see it. That sucks. So we're going to have this going to be a lot of testing just to get rid of the rough edges. this yeah, part of the game. See? Now you get a whole lot of stuff here. So deep is the search there, so we can remove that. This is going to take a while. Then we have far live search for Dubious Launch. Because it needs to search for a lab to get to and it this goes for everyone by the way, so we need to basically search that stuff. Search for system DBSD for lab T system DBSD for live T. Then for everyone that's doing that, we need to basically allow this. And that's just the beginning, because they also need to go traverse far, but that's probably taken care of yeah already. So that's the stuff you don't usually see. Needs to traverse. You can't go there if you can't traverse the parent Earth. It's just the way it is. Although I'm probably already required, but go ready to have that. So we're done now with this. This session execute this launch. We have a bunch of these session stuff here. Where is the session? So let's just paste this here on top and work our way through it. So debris launch. This one, debris launch. Where's debris launch? It's getting not run the debris session. But I guess debris session must be able to do that. So what we're going to do is my login user G session T. I'm gonna paint all this stuff. So that G session runs debris launch in the user. If the session runs debris launch in the debris launch domain, that's it. Those are the others. And that's basically with regard to the oh, the same stuff happens for IAM set check. So let's just do that as well. And I'm not saying that it actually runs it, maybe it's just mapping it, but assume that the file ID is allowed. Then we have some login user stuff here. That's all the way on top. Let's just so yeah, search, and I'll make a get attribute out of that as well. And then config home unsets config home to that's here. And it's a dir search. So yeah. Then we have some stuff with regards to XVG user update. XVG. Once it's off, yeah, once you traverse the route, home route 2. Makes sense. So it's also allowed that attribute. That stuff, and that's basically it. But that's more, don't worry. Don't worry about that. I'm going to at least do some kill all stuff, and actually also, well, first just do kill all. Kill all you, my login user, make sure that that stuff is dead. So we are at 10:43. This. As Linux config. Search. Get attribute. Dbus launch. Dbus launch. I'll leave that for now. Actually, that's really stupid. If you want to read something, maybe it's just checking for read though, but probably not. For like before insert chat. said check. Well, I'll be damned. It must be the socket. That's all we have. So we're gonna have to kill this. Use 10:42 anyways. This is not related, this is not related, this is. ABRT Apple. Basis in. So we have a search for the dirt that makes sense. This one. This all makes sense. Now it's not very clean, but. Port config country actually this search we can remove that abort config country. This one is done. Abort etc, get attribute search. Board for cash. Board for cash. Search. We can remove that. Deconf home to. Yeah, that's needed to get to data home to. Abort etc, there, yeah, we had that, and these can remain. XP wants to. So it's doing something at home there. Then it's a good search. And Canberra. Oops. Canberra is doing a lot of stuff. Executing pools. Where is Canberra? So let's just add it on top and fill it in. Conflict home. Conflict home. Is that any difference in conflict? Not that I know, but. Get attribute. Search. File descriptor use. And then basically we need to basically make Canberra transition to Pulse Audio. Make Canberra transition to Pulse Audio. Is it writing anything? And I'll leave this one out for now. And Pulse Audio home key. The repeat attribute. So basically that needs to be, that's for everyone. So Pulse Audio home key the search. Where is Pulse Audio home key search, and then add reading attribute. Read get with search. This is just that. Alright. So Canberra needs to run Pulse Audio. Pulse Audio. Basically everyone needs to do that. Pulse Audio. So basically we're going to have the Canberra added here. And they don't actually need to fully run it though. But still. Everyone needs to do this. Everyone that uses Pulse Audio needs to be able to do that. Okay, let's take we took care of that. We have Dbus search in Homebrew T. Dbus. Then we have Cuba's lunch being possible, that's allowed already. And then we have deconf searching, deconf config country. Also makes sense. Then we have the admon, a bunch of stuff. So this is basically the rough edges. Config home 2 search makes sense for deconf. Yeah, deconf. Deconf home T, yeah, makes sense for data. Is it actually doing some data stuff? Not yet, but I guess it will be. Get attribute search. I guess it will be going to data home key. DNS segmon. Let's just add it here for a while and work through it. So cache home key search. Do we have some business in cache? Sorry. No, we don't. But we do have business here. So we can remove that. Ibis config home T. The search. We have fonts. We have font cache is set attribute and search. Actually, and we have fonts to search. Then we have this write, but I'm going to do that later. And then the cache home. Okay, that's this certain bit attribute. Evo alarm. Where is Evo alarm? I have it here for a while. Config home T. Yeah, that makes sense. Put it here. Evo Cal Factory, same stuff. That's for actually not for there, but actually let's just get that, put that in the right place. So there is some system in where I put the stuff. Evo source wedge. I'm not just posting it just anywhere. Actually thinking about that carefully. Config home key. Evolution config home key the search. And data home key search the. I'll remove that. Gconf D2. So we have gconf etc the foot. Makes sense. Home root key search. Get attribute. Not sure why it's wanna search home, but probably good reason for that. Yeah, yeah. This is the reason. And then it's also need to traverse user home dirty. Oh, it's already done there. GOID. Actually, I'll put it here. So we have user temp tether search. That makes sense. And we have config DOA config home tether search. Also makes sense. Then we have check acceleration. Session. Using the user file descriptor, they all need that. Or actually not all, but and then we have a bunch of stuff here, this session. This above. And this was for G-session config home tether search. G-session config. Damn, where am I? G-session config home tether search. Config search. What else? Shell exec. It's the empty search. Data convert. Set. File descriptor. And then this set is going to start. This set D. Okay. I'll just add that here temporarily. Get some stuff to test home the right. Test home the right. Why does it need to write the test home the right? Done it. Let someone remove these for now. Cups, etc. I'll just put that in here. Get attribute as well. Same goes for this one. Fonts cache the search so that to get attribute fonts the search. Hardware data the search get attribute and then the same for this image get attribute though it's not needed I think but same for this one. Okay, use home the right, that makes sense. Pulse audio temp to the search. Should be it. Although I need to basically require cups DT. And hardware data is already done. Full monitor, default of full monitor. GVFS Christ DVFS. UDEF warranty. Get an attribute search. This read doesn't make sense. Get attribute search. Right. We're far from here. A lot of stuff to be done. DVFS. Use a 10T search, and that's then we have IM set D. Config home T, and that's basically makes sense. Data home T, then it needs to be searching gconf, makes sense. Then we have dconf 10t. What does it need to do there? Search. And then we have imset cache on to the search. Okay, insert S. Insert. This is just a file using the file descriptor. Network manager applet. Edit here for a while. Cache home T. Does it have business in cache home T? Don't see what business it has in cache home T, but allow it anyways. Then we have fonts cache the search get attribute, and that makes sense. And then we have, and I'll also allow get attribute, although this is just a library. Forms the search. And this, I'll skip this for a while. Pulse audio, can search pulse audio 10T. Asia Blitz. Hungry to make sense. This is stuff that we can ignore. Here we have two minor effects. Now the space is in here. This is the file descriptor, that's fine. TR minor effects config home to the search. TR minor effects config. Get attribute search. And data home search the TR store data home. The TR store data home. The search. Okay. TR store. TR store. And what does it say? So we have this TR minor config home. This is TR minor config home. This is search. Get attribute. And then page up, and then remove that here. VDA agent. VDA agent. VDA agent. This is simply a... This needs a lot more, obviously. And we're there again, except I don't know why XDM wants sysadmin. Now fix the bugs. Oh, actually there aren't any. And that's something. I do like it. 20,000 of these test runs, and then we might be getting somewhere. getting something. We're getting something, but not much. These can be ignored. This is allowed in current policy, but this isn't. Abort fart crash. So, abort applets. ABRT apple. Fart crash. ABRT fart crash. Then it's their right. So it's actually trying to create something there. Damn. That means that there's going to have to be a file there. Yeah, abort forecast, right? Am I right? Yeah, forecast. Right. Yeah, here's the search is loud. Here's trying to open a file. This is allowed. This one is allowed, but this one isn't allowed. So I'll put this knife on top somewhere. That's allowed. This is allowed. This isn't, shouldn't be allowed. This is allowed. And we have a Canberra open for the. And this is what kind of the Canberra. Tools Audio Home Dir. Tools Audio Home 2. It's open. And it makes sense. So Tools Audio Home 2 Dir. Make sure everything is open. It's also set out to good. Eventually. Alright, on to the next. So we took care of that open. Then we have this user home dir right. Now for Pulse Audio that makes, oh, Canberra that makes sense. Print the execute, debus, search user, and shell execute. This. That's all gravy. Deconf user attempt to search. Deconf user attempt to search. Yeah, it needs to be able to do that. Get it. this is allowed, this is allowed, this is allowed, this is allowed, this one is allowed, this one is allowed, this one is allowed, this one is allowed, and then we have here some stuff that is not allowed, Demon Sacramon, and it is a home girl, right? I don't know what it is right now. DNSSecMon, and it's basically sending a signal to itself. So I'll just add that somewhere there. Alright, then we have Evo at his factory. Evo Address. That's, I'll just add it here for now. Config home key. This makes sense. Let's make that a certificate attribute. And then evolution data home key, the cert makes sense. Oops. Allowed. 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 And we have the contact search provider doing things. Gcon. We can add that. I'm just adding it here for now. Cache home key search. Okay, now that's fine. Get attribute to search then. And then config home key search. That makes sense. Then we have the remaining context data home trigger search. Context data. Context data home trigger search. Alright, on to the next. This one is loud, this one is loud. We have GSD printer. GSD printer. And these are simple. I'm just adding here. Paste. And then basically what I'm going to do is allow search. I'll get attribute here. I get search. This DSD printer. Allows. Well, here we have GZB writing to cache home key, but I wasn't sure what it's writing. I'm not sure what it's writing there. Here we have some truckload of GNOME shell stuff. GNOME shell wants to execute pulse audio. G shell. And let's just add it somewhere here. So we have cache home. Search get attribute, I guess. Get attribute. Let's just add a good attribute here as well. Then we have certigger search. Makes sense. get attribute search. Then we have forms cache the search set attribute. Makes sense. But we also need get attribute. And we also will allow get attribute for C groups. Get attribute. Fonts the search makes sense. File descriptor makes sense. This shell executes pulse audio. Pulse audio home T does open. Pulse audio home T does open. Seems we like that. Login D foreign T. Login D foreign T and it's search. Makes sense. Login D foreign T. And we need to get attribute there as well. Udef search the Udef search the get attribute get attribute and then allow shell to run pulse audio. So that's basically this, but then different. All these apps need to basically run Pulse Audio. G-shell. I'm just going to copy this one over. Okay. Cal D. Says config home T. D cal D. That doesn't. Is it D shell cal D? D shell cal D. So it's doing some config hunt and it makes sense. This stuff, most of this stuff just make perfect sense if you think like the file system. You need to traverse certain directories to get to them, but you probably already know by now, but just underscoring that some of that stuff just really makes sense. Loud. These nuts. We need to allow this one. Now search provider. Where is? Now search P. Tconf home T and that's for this one here. Makes sense. Get attribute for this for the shits and giggles. Where are we? then we have some other stuff here for network manager, applet, signal. NM, and I'll do this NM apple. What's the signal itself? Basically add that signal, and they all should basically be able to signal set yet. That's one thing I figured out, that eventually all these apps all need signal and set yet, but for now I'll just do it this way. Where am I? No, it's applet. So here we have pulse audio stuff. Three, and also all these pulse audios need to send signals. Pulse audio needs to send signal to everyone. So we're far, far from anywhere close. Those are just patterns that you'll see after a while. Init foreign T. I thought I added some init foreign T stuff. Guess I didn't. Git. So basically, all these domains need to be able to send nil signals to each other. All of them. And then we have more. We have UDEF RNT search. UDEF RNT does search. And that makes sense. Get up for good search. This is allowed, this is allowed, and we have a truckload of stuff that we don't need to allow. Then we have here mission control doing its thing. TPMC, and this was TPMC data home T dir search. TPMC data home T dir search. Yeah. This is allowed, this is allowed, this is allowed. This is allowed, this is allowed, this is allowed. This isn't allowed, but that shouldn't be allowed. This isn't allowed, shouldn't be allowed. And we're there again. Does it build? No, it doesn't. Syntax error. Online 3298. Where is it? The fuck? Three, two, nine, eight. What's that? Let's see if I'm getting clues. A syntax error adds, and then oh, so bracket, there's a bracket issue. Oh, Christ. Okay, do it again. And we don't have audio. Pulse audio craps out, so that's probably a lot of pulse audio related issues. This is loud, this is loud, this isn't loud here. It's I should probably just retry this in permissive again. ABRT Apple, and then abort forecast stuff. Where are you? Here. And it's add name here. Because it's trying to create a file. Abort forecast. There, yeah. And then this is allowed. Loud, this is loud, that's loud, this is loud, and here we have a set to do for pulse audio, and I'm going to do that everywhere, pulse audio, because I know that, pulse audio, home t, der, and it's going to have all set attributes, except this one. Set attribute. This has a set attribute. Set attribute. This has a set attribute. Set attribute. This has a set attribute. Set attributes. And there we have them all, I guess. Okay. Where am I? Where am I? This was loud. This is loud. This is loud. This wasn't loud. And this, I don't know what it is. I should fix that. This is all gravy. Yep, this is all gravy. This is loud. This isn't loud, but it shouldn't be loud. Yep, it's fine. This is 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 fine. That's also fine. And this is fine. And we have it. We need to basically really do this stuff here. This is only right. This is done. 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 That's done. That's done. That's done. This is done. Yep, 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 yep. Here we have some stuff. Oh, that's done. This is all right. This is all done. Here we have some. Just hope. Oh yeah, that's something I didn't understand. So I need to figure that out as well. This is done. Yes, yes. Copy. We are going to G shell, and then it's IEBIS. Oh, this is not it though. G shell, I need G shell. Do we have an IEBIS here? Maybe, oh here. Search. And then we can remove this one here. Back. Okay, where the hell was I? Gnome shell. I allowed that one. I need to figure it out. We need also. And as you see, it needs to send signals all over the place. Pulse audio. So I might as well just do that right away. First, also read write. The search get attribute. That fitted nicely right in there. And then here you have those signals. And I'll just do an expansion here. So I now shall my login user. Everyone that runs it, basically, well, just. Yeah, G shell. Canberra. So my login user G shell key Canberra. They all need it. If it runs, pulls audio, then it needs it. And GZD, we already had GZD, yep. This allowed, this needs to be a loud signal, send signal to itself. Self process signal. Currently allowed. This is not applicable, this is allowed. That's okay. And then we are there. So now basically, user home dirty, right. So, grab user home dirty, grab, right. Yeah, but this doesn't tell me anything about why it's needing to write. Let's have a look at it. Actually, we'll figure that out in the next one. Let's log out. And actually, we're able to log out. Wow. That's special. Let's just build this. So we are getting closer. Yes, we are. Well, we're going to go back to permissive mode, and hopefully now we're getting some more clues. But first, let's just kill. And then clear my login user shell, and then lsalzdemp. Now we have fuel pulse audio, rmrf temp, and remove those, and also this one. So done. Now what we're gonna do is set 740 and our search mabcts1154, and we're gonna take a break soon. Actually, I'm gonna take a break right now, and we'll resume.